Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to walk you through the various different certifications available from AWS and give you some guidance on where you should start your cloud certification journey. Now, the good news is that anybody can do any AWS certification. So you can start right down at the foundational level, or you could even start at the professional or specialty level. Now, I wouldn't recommend that. I do recommend that you sort of build up your knowledge, but I'm just letting you know that anybody can take any AWS certification exam at any time, and if you pass the exam, then you earn that certification. Once you've earned a certification, you now have that certification for a validity period of 3 years. After the 3 years, your certification does expire, and you'll need to recertify to regain that certification. In some cases, getting a higher level certification will recertify you at the lower level. For example, if you pass the Solutions Architect Professional exam, it will recertify you at the Solutions Architect Associate level. And there's more information about that on the AWS website. The certification that you get started with really depends on a couple of key factors. One is, how much experience do you have, both in AWS, in cloud technology, and also in IT in general. The second thing is, what job role do you do, or what job role are you trying to move into? Once you know those two things, then it's a bit easier to try and work out the best starting level. So let's go over the different certifications that are available, and I'll give you some tips as to where you might want to start. So at the very bottom level, we have the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner. This is a foundational level certification. So it's a very good starting point. Now, I think it's a great starting point for anyone who's new to the AWS cloud. Doesn't matter how much experience you have in IT. Now, the reason I say that is because there's certain knowledge specific to individual certifications that might not come up too much in other ones. Now, the cloud practitioner really starts at the very beginning. It teaches you the benefits of cloud, teaches you some of the architectural principles that we use and the best practices working in the cloud, and it teaches you quite a bit about the support models and the pricing models that are available. So it's a really great starting point for everyone, and if you already have experience in the industry, you'll find it a breeze. Above the foundational level, we then have the associate level. So at the foundational level, AWS recommend you have about 6 months of experience. At the associate level, they're looking for about 1 year of experience. And at the associate level, you have three different certifications which are designed for specific roles. So if you're an architect, you're going to be looking towards the Solutions Architect Associate. And to be fair, most people start with that one anyway. So almost everybody who learns about AWS and gets certified is going to do the Architect Associate. Next, we have a certification that's most suitable for those performing an operations role. So that's the AWS Certified SysOps Administrator Associate. So if you work in systems administration, then that's an ideal certification to take. Now, that's probably the hardest of the associate level certifications. I typically recommend that those who want to do the SysOps Associate do the Architect Associate first, and maybe even the Developer Associate. Now, the Developer Associate is for those who are performing a development role working with AWS. Now, don't worry if you don't know anything about development itself, you can still pass this certification. You don't actually need to be able to write any code to do our training courses and be able to pass the Developer Associate exam. So, which one would you take? Well, as I mentioned, most people do the Solutions Architect Associate. If you're working in a development role, you'll definitely want to do the Developer Associate as well. And it's a great one for everyone, just to give you a broader understanding of AWS. The SysOps Administrator Associate is probably the least popular of the associate levels, but because it's that bit more difficult, I think it's a really great one to attain because it gives you more operational knowledge of AWS, and it will really differentiate you if you have that certification. Above the associate level, we then have the professional level. Now, between the foundational level and the associate level, there's quite a big jump in difficulty. At the associate level, the questions become a bit more complex. They're all scenario-based questions, and they really test quite a deep understanding of AWS. At the professional level, it's another big jump up. The questions get a lot longer, more complex, and involve more different services. So you really need to have some solid experience. AWS recommend you have 2 years. Now, if you've done the foundational and the associate levels, which I recommend you do all of those certifications before you move to professional level, that will really set you up well. And many people do attain the professional level without actually having worked with AWS technology. At the professional level, we have two different options. So you can either go down the solutions architect professional road, or you can do the DevOps engineer professional. Now, the DevOps engineer professional sits above the SysOps and the developer associate training. So it's a kind of a combination of those two. It's probably a bit easier than the architect professional exam, but they're both very difficult exams. Now you'll see alongside the core certifications, we have the specialty certifications. Now these are where you have a deep level of domain expertise in a specific area. So we've got security, we've got advanced networking, we've got machine learning, database and data analytics. So these will dive really deep on those particular areas of knowledge. Now I highly recommend you don't go straight into a specialty level. Make sure you've earned at least the associate level before you do them. They can be quite tricky, sometimes a bit easier than professional level. With other ones, they can be at a similar level to the professional difficulty of exam. Now, at the specialty level, there is a level of assumed knowledge. So, for example, in our training courses, we're going to teach you everything you need to know to pass those exams, but we do assume that you come in with a certain level of knowledge of the fundamentals of AWS before you get started. And that's why you should do other certification exams before you do your specialties. Now, of course, everyone's different. This is just my guidance. You can do whatever you want to do. If you have a solid level of knowledge as a security specialist and you've worked with AWS, then maybe the security specialty exam, for example, is something you can do straight off. But for most people, that's not the way you're going to approach it. So that's it for this video. I wish you all the best in your certification journey. And please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like this video if you want to see more like this.